Okay, so in today's notes, we're going to take a look at circles in the coordinate plane. So at the top of the page, we're going to take a look at the equations of circles. And notice that the equations are in a center radius form. Okay, so in order to write the equation of a circle, we need both the center and radius. So on the left side, the equation of a circle with center HK, where H represents the x-coordinate and K represents the y-coordinate, and you're given, and you have a radius R, the equation is this. X minus H squared plus Y minus K squared equals R squared. Okay? When the center is right at 0, 0, or the origin, there's a different form of the equation. And if you have radius r, the equation is x squared plus y squared equals r squared. Now, if you'd like to see where these equations come from, you can continue watching for a moment. Otherwise, just skip past it. But as I mentioned at the beginning of the year, it's not just the what, it's the why. So given center HK, and let's call this point XY. So you need, okay, XY in both scenarios is a point on the circle. Okay. Now, you should recognize this. It looks very similar to the Pythagorean theorem. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. So if I make a right triangle, draw straight across and then straight down from there, over here, straight across, straight down, and they would meet there. Now, what is first the other point of the triangle in both? Now, this point shares the same x value as the point above and the same y value as the point across. So this would actually be xk. And this one would have the same x value as above and the same y value as across, so 0. Now, if we actually take a look at the length of these sides, so this side right here, you have your y value is the same. So you take the absolute value of x minus h, which you see here. And then this side right here, your x's are the same. So this side right here would be the absolute value of y minus k, which you see right here. And then, of course, your hypotenuse is the r. So a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So over here, your horizontal distance, you're going from 0 to x, is just going to be x. And then your vertical distance, you're going from 0 to y, is just going to be y. So here's the x squared. So a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So if you had to and you could graph it on some graph paper in the coordinate plane, you could just use the Pythagorean theorem. Okay. So let's write these equations of circles A and B. So in both cases, just take for a moment and note the center and radius of each. So where is that point that's equidistant from all the points on the circle, and what is the radius? The one on the left has a center of negative 1, 1. The one on the right has a center at the origin. The radius of this one is 3. Moving to the left, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, I'm going to start with the one on the right because the center is at 0, 0. So it just starts x squared plus y squared equals the radius squared. So 3 squared would be 9. The one on the left side. So it's x minus h. Remember the h is just the x of the center, k is the y. So x minus, so when I subtract that negative 1, that turns plus. So x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared, and 4 squared is 16. And one thing to note, too, just to help you with the multiple choice question at the bottom, whatever the center is, the coordinates are the opposite. So opposite of negative 1 is positive 1, and in parentheses, opposite of a positive 1 is negative 1. All right, number 2. Write the equation of each circle. So we're doing the same thing. It's just this time we don't have the picture. We have it written out in words. So we have circle A with center of 1, negative 8, and then the radius of 7. So this is going to start x minus the h, which is a 1 squared, plus y minus the y value of the center squared equals radius squared, and 7 squared is 49. And you just want to go back to change that subtraction of a negative to a positive. The one on the right, so it's at the origin, the center. We're going to do x squared plus y squared equals r squared. Well, if r is the square root of 6, r squared is the square root of 6 squared. And that square undoes the square root, and the answer is just 6. Or if you'd like to see it out, radical 6 times radical 6 is the square root of 36, which is 6. So multiple choice, which is an equation of the circle whose center is 2, negative 3, and whose radius is 4? I would, with these questions, focus on the radius, because the equation of a circle, in both, they're both equal to r squared. And 4 squared is 16. So it has to be equal to 16, which puts it down to 50-50. And then, as we said before, if this is a positive 2 for x, it's x minus 2, so it's not going to be x plus, it's going to be this equation number 4, because the opposite also of a negative 3 is positive 3. And flipping to the back, so find the center and radius of each circle given the equation. So when it's x squared plus y squared, the center is 0, 0, because if you do the x minus 0 squared plus y minus 0 squared, you just end up with that x squared plus y squared. And then remember, it's equal to r squared, so what squared gave us 25? We have a radius of 5. So over here with the x squared, remember, it must have been x minus 0 squared. So if there's no plus or minus to the x, the first coordinate is 0. And then the opposite of positive 1 is negative 1. When the number to the right of the equal sign, which is supposed to be your r squared, is a number that's not a perfect square, then the radius is just going to be the square root of whatever that number is. And if you wanted to think of it as an equation, r squared equals 3, you have to take the square root, and r is plus or minus radical 3, rejecting the negative. Okay, moving right along to the general form. So I'm going to read the general form and highlight some things, and then I'm going to scroll it up so I have more room for number 5. It says the general form of the equation of a circle is ax squared plus bx plus cy squared plus dy plus e equals 0. So just like your quadratic, when you graph it, you want it equal to 0. The same goes for a circle. To write a circle in general form, we want to square each binomial in the center radius form and combine like terms. So once we actually write it, we're going to do the math and expand. So let's take a look at this question here. We've got a center of 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. So our center is 4, 3, and our radius is 1, 2, 3. So I'm going to first write the equation of the circle, which is going to be x minus 4 squared plus y minus 3 squared equals radius squared, is 9. Now, once I write that, we have to actually do the math and square the binomials and then also combine like terms. So x minus 4 squared is x minus 4 times x minus 4. So I'm going to distribute x times x, x squared, minus 4x, minus 4x, plus 16. So this combines to x squared minus 8x plus 16. Now I'm going to square y minus 3. So that means y minus 3 times y minus 3. And I'm going to bring the 9 over at this point so that it's equal to 0. So that's by subtraction. So I'm squaring this binomial. We have y squared minus 3, y to minus, or minus y times negative 3 and then negative 3 times y. Together is negative 6y. So I was just doing that in my head. And negative 3 times negative 3 is a positive 9. Okay, these 9's go away. Because 9 minus 9 is 0. Bringing this down. And this is what we've got. Now it's close. It just wants the x squared term, then x, then the y squared term, y, and then the number, then equal to 0. So I'm going to use the commutative property to move things around. So it wants the x squared term, then the x term, the y squared term, and the y term, and then the number equals 0. So that's an expanded or general form. On the next page, we're going to use, I'm just reading the box, it says we can use completing the square to change a circle in general form, which is given, which we just looked at, to a circle in center radius form. All we do, again, we're going to complete the square, but instead of adding one box, we're going to add two. Okay, so I'm going to use, so if I'm looking at A, directions are to find the center and radius. Well, once I get it in this form, then I can easily spot the center and radius. So I'm going to use the commutative property to move things around. So I'm going to take the x terms, so x squared and 8x, move them so that they're right next to each other, and then add the box for that trinomial. So we'll fill the boxes in just a second. Now we're going to take the y terms and put them next to each other. Minus 6y plus the box. And then I'm going to add the 75 over now. And I need to add, again, two boxes to this side because whatever you add to one side of an equation, you must add to the other. So let's complete the square for the first trinomial in the middle with x. So if you remember from algebra 1, the c value when you complete the square is half of the b. So let's just recall for a trinomial, it's ax squared plus bx plus c. So this c right here is half of b, which is 4. 4 squared is 16. So to complete the trinomial with y, half of the b, negative 6 is negative 3, negative 3 squared is 9. So I just completed the square twice. Then we're going to rewrite it as the square of the binomials so that it looks like this format right here. So I'm going to factor. This factors x times x, and then the factors of 16 that combine to 8 are 4 and 4. And we're going to rewrite that as x plus 4 squared. The factors of a positive 9 in the y trinomial that combine to negative 6 is y minus 3 times y minus 3. Negative 3 plus negative 3 is negative 6. And then negative 3 times negative 3 is 9. So this is y minus 3 squared. And combining the right side, 75, 69 and 9 I know is 25. So 75 plus 25 is 100. So now in that format, we can easily spot the center and radius. The center comes from these two numbers right here. Remember, it's opposite. So our center is negative 4, 3. And our radius is here, and it's equal to r squared. So it must be 10 in order to square 10 to get 100. And we're going to practice this one more time. Okay, if you're good, you can skip it, but I feel like it's good to have more practice. So using the commutative property to put the x terms together so that we can complete that square. And then the y terms. You want the number over on the other side, so when you add that, it becomes positive. And then we're going to add the two boxes. Half of 10 is 5, 5 squared, 25. Half of negative 4 is negative 2, and negative 2 squared is 4. So adding the 25 and 4 to that side. Now I'm going to skip the step of factoring. We know it's going to be the square of some binomial. So if you set it up as the square of some binomial, okay, these two numbers are always what doubles to give you the middle and squares to the last. So it doubles to 10 is 5, and then 5 squared is 25. And then here, what doubles to negative 4 is negative 2, and negative 2 squared is 4. And then 7 plus 25 plus 4 is 36. So now I can see the center and radius. I'm looking here for the center. So the center is negative 5, 2, because it's the opposite sign. And then our radius is 6. And then last is just to graph a circle in the coordinate plane. And to graph, we need to start with the center and radius. So our center is negative 1, negative 3, and our radius is 4. So start by plotting the center first. And this is a 10 by 10 grid. So left 1, down 3. So here's my center. Now the radius is 4, so from the center, count up 1, 2, 3, 4. Count right 1, 2, 3, 4. Down 1, 2, 3, 4. Left from the center 1, 2, 3, 4. And then just take your compass or sketch it by hand. You just don't want it to look like a diamond. And put your compass point at the center and line it up with one of your points. And if it goes through that one, when you draw the circle, it should go through all of the other three.